is playing detective as he digs deep to locate the missing money, with little help from Hamish now in Shortland Street.
So that's it. You'll have my resignation in writing. In the meantime, I'm out of here.
Have you spoken to Andrew?
No, not since yesterday, but I heard what happened.
I've never seen him so fired up.
He's been pretty unstable for a while now.
Hamish, what's happened?
That 2,500? It was transferred into Andrew Solomon's personal account. The bastard's helped himself to hospital funds.
Andrew, it's Huya again. When you get this message, can you please call me urgently? Thank you.
Is there anything I can do to help?
Yeah. Find Andrew for me.
I mean, why would he do something like this? I mean, it's 2,500. It's not exactly major dosh.
We don't know that he has.
You two were the only ones with the PIN numbers.
Yes, hi. I need to contact one of your guests. Dr. Andrew Solomon. Okay, thanks. He's checked out.
Where are you going?
Out.
This baby thing.
Yes, Norman, I am having your baby. No, I haven't picked any names yet.
Okay, see, that's it. I need to know that you're serious.
I am. I really am. Come on, spit it out.
Is this about us, or is it about Jay? Are you doing it to cut Jay and Myra out of the mix? Because if you are, babe, I can't cope with that. It's a terrible reason to have a child.
Okay. On one level, it is about Jay. It's what I said last night. I'm not into the whole extended family thing. I don't want to be dealing with a half-brother or half-sister and Maya and Jay pestering us and wanting us to be a happy family, blah, blah, blah. I'm sorry, but that's the way it is. Besides, I don't even like Jay.
And on another level?
It's easy. I love you and I want to make you happy.
And you do really want to have this baby?
Yes.
You can't let me down on this, Lee. It's too important.
I'm not going to let you down. I promise. We're only going to have one, and it's going to have a traditional old-fashioned name, and you can wheel it around until it's old enough to have a proper conversation.
Done.
Did he not tell you he and Robin flew out today?
Is this temporary or permanent?
Permanent. They're going to set up house in some sweet little village in the counties. He wants to be a GP.
Right. Any idea why he took off in a hurry?
Probably because Nutba, who's having his children, talked him into it.
Yeah, I'd go along with that one. Do you have an address in the UK?
No, but you can email him or text him. He took his mobile.
But I wouldn't hang out for a quick answer. He wanted to forget all about work. Okay, if he calls in the meantime, would you ask him to get in touch with me?
Sure.
Okay. Thanks.
See ya.
Bye.
What was that all about?
We have to make an offer on that cottage.
Can't wait till the auction.
I don't want to wait. And we don't want someone snatching it away from us at the last minute.
Oh, I hope you're going to be this fired up about getting pregnant. So, when are we planning on having this baby? Not right now, I know, but ballpark, you know? 6 months? A year?
I haven't figured it out yet. It's not easy. It's going to mean time out for my career.
Yeah, so we need to be organised. Which is a good reason to set a date. Look, babe, we both know how lucky I was with the cancer. But hey, I might not stay clear forever. And I want to spend as much time with this kid as possible. That's why Jay and I have decided on March.
If you want me to get pregnant right now...
I don't, okay? I'm just saying, we need to start thinking about a time frame.
All right. I'll talk to Chris tomorrow.
Good. Then I'll talk to Jay.
You haven't told her?
Mike, when have I had the chance
to... You could have phoned her. soon as Norman, I want her name off that donor list.
I'll take her off the list, but not until you and I have plans in place. Once we've set a date, then I'll tell Jay.
No way. Andrew was always so straight. He was like Captain Monochrome.
Well, he was a loose unit there for a while, always propping up the Barrett Coal Train. Jay said the way he lost it whenever Robin was around was scary.
He's certainly had his trials lately.
Yeah, well, having Robin turn up pregnant to your wedding would be enough to unhinge anyone.
Do you guys mind turning down the volume, please?
Hey, how about that social club, Yvonne? Is it dead as a doornail, or is that just a rumour?
Oh, well, what do you think, girls? Wine trail? Day at the races?
Wine trail could be good. We could do the Waiheke Vineyards.
No, that's what plonkers. We should do a car rally or hire out some four-wheel drives to take off down a beach.
Oh, please. Why do people do that?
Okay, a rally with a big prize and Barbie at the end.
Not bad.
I always get lost on rallies.
Isn't that the point?
Hey, Claire, you could help organise it.
True, or I could walk in front of a bus.
Mum, you look terrible.
Oh, don't be silly. It's just a cold.
So go home. Is this what sick leave's for?
Tanya's right. You should go home. There's enough germs brewing around here without the staff adding to the mix.
What am I going to do at home? All by myself.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. Why don't you come to my place? I'll drop you off and you can put your feet up and I'll cook us dinner when I get home.
Aren't you lovely?
Or you can come to our place.
You know, Finny and Jay don't mind.
Well, Hamish is offered now.
You're late.
You want to start giving me wake-up calls now?
Summer, we've got that 30th birthday party on tonight. Oh, to one on Matthews, the guy who spends a lot of money in here, could spend more. So, if you haven't done a big order, you better get back out there.
Oh, but the markets would have sold all the good stuff by now.
Well, don't make it sound like it's my fault. Here, get on the phone, find a supermarket and get your act together.
Yeah, but I still got to prep the trolley and do the hospital run.
And you're committed to tapas for 40 people tonight. Or you can go out there and you can tell Norman that you don't want this contract because it's way more fun slacking off.
Slacking off?
Yes.
Okay, look, I'll have the basics if I cut down on the lunch menu.
Oh, great. So either way, our customers miss out. That is so professional.
If I could just get hold of him and talk to him.
A cheeky ride for that patient. It's kind of a weird coincidence that the same amount ended up in his account. It's not very intelligent.
Neither is leaving the country in a hurry.
Are we sure it's not just an accounting stuffer?
Positive. I've checked.
Andrew doesn't strike me as having the bottle to do something like this. To be honest, I found him an uptight git most of the time.
Well, it could just be him giving the up yours to the DHB.
Maybe. The CAS business, you don't think he's involved there?
Chris, I don't want to think he's involved anywhere in this. But all I can do is look at what's in front of me. The questionnaires are a joke. None of my contacts have ever heard of CAS. They have no street address, and all I get when I call is an answer phone.
He handed over $50,000 to this crowd?
Yes.
Are they a registered company?
They're not on the company's list, no.
So who the hell are they?
I don't know. But they didn't waste any time presenting the cheque. I should get this. Who are you, Samuels? In what name? Thanks. Well, there's one question answered. That was the bank. Someone by the name of Richard Minogue is the sole signatory to the CAS account. The account was cleaned out and closed yesterday. So 2.5 on top of 50,000 down the drain. Should I involve the police in this?
Not yet. Get the paperwork sorted, take it to the DHB, let the lawyers decide.
The DHB are going to want someone's head on a plate, and if they can't have Andrew's...
I know. It's not a good feeling.